A boutique chocolate company in Wellington is looking for a brand new chocolate flavour. The thing is, they want children, not adults, to create it.
Whichever kid convinces the Wellington Chocolate Factory to take on their flavour will get their product on the shelves and a chocolate factory tour that'll even make Charlie jealous. Here's Julian Lee.
The Wellington Chocolate Factory is just so... how do I put this? Wellington. Gabe's the first to admit it.
It's a little bit arty, a little bit edgy, our chocolate, and we want to sort of expand people's idea of what real chocolate is. And then we use some great New Zealand and Wellington artists on our wrappers, so trying to keep it interesting and fun. If you're not greedy,
you will go far. Is it true that Gabe is known as the Willy Wonka of Wellington?
I have been known to be called Willy Wonka. Yeah, I'm not sure. Maybe the more the Gene Wilder than the Johnny Depp.
And now, New Zealand's very own version of the golden ticket.
My dream was always to open a chocolate factory, and we thought while all the Kiwi kids are at home, we could give them the opportunity to dream up a chocolate bar flavour and design a wrapper and make their own chocolate bar and encourage, I don't know, a new generation of chocolate makers. We want them to go crazy in the kitchen. We want them to come up with radical new ideas and really have fun with the flavours and with the artwork. 'Cause I can't get
enough. One lucky kid and their family will win a trip to Wellington for the weekend with accommodation, trips to Zealandia, the zoo, Weta Workshop, and, of course, the chocolate factory. Their chocolate bar will be sold at the supermarkets and they'll personally wrap the first one off the line.
We've had a few adults disgruntled that they can't enter already, so I think we might consider doing a competition in the future. We'll see about that.
And Gabe's open to anything. He's already pretty adventurous. The National War Museum commissioned Gabe to come up with Anzac chocolate. The artwork had to be signed off by military historians and Sir Peter Jackson himself.
We decided to use some of the ingredients in the ration bar that they gave out to the soldiers during World War I and put a Kiwi Aussie twist on it by having Anzac cookies jammed in the back.
What is the weirdest chocolate flavour you've ever heard of worldwide?
There was a good one recently in the States, and somebody's created an avocado on toast bar.
Has it worked?
It was very popular, they sold out. I'm sure it was delicious. It was green.
I know this can sound crazy, but I think it can be done, and I'll explain what. I've got two ideas, fish and chip flavour, and a hungy flavour. What do
you reckon? Fish and chip and hungy.
Yeah.
Oh, I love it. No one's ever come up with those as suggestions for ideas. The chip, maybe. Salt works well with chocolate. The fish, maybe not so much the fish.
And so what about the hungy flavour? You know, your pork, you know, your potato, you know, bit of pumpkin maybe.
It'd be interesting to get a little smoky flavours happening in the chocolate. That could be quite nice. But, I don't know if meat and chocolate go together so well.
And for those future chocolatiers aged 5 to 13, here's your in. If you can beat fish and chips chocolate, apparently you're already ahead of the pack.
Fish and chip fish, Julian, fish.
No, 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 no.
No way.